Morning students, so far we are completed the first unit, second unit and the third unit. The first unit, four chapters. The first one is deleted, so reproduction in organism is deleted. Then the sexual reproduction in flowering plants, human reproduction and reproductive health is over. And the second unit comprises three lessons, that is principles of inheritance and variations, molecular basis of inheritance and evolution. In the three, evolution is deleted. So first two chapters are completed. And the third chapter, the third unit, microbes in human welfare, human health and diseases, strategies for food enhancement. In these three chapters, strategies for food enhancement is deleted. So remaining two is over. So far we are completed three units. The total units, five units. So far we are completed three units. And the next unit is biotechnology. And the last unit is environment. Last unit in environment, environment lesson, environment ecology and environment, four chapters are present. Out of four chapters, two chapters is deleted for your board exams. Only two chapters is present. So organisms and population and biodiversity conservation. So organism and population, I'll talk about first. Organism and population. What is meant by organisms? Organisms are group of population, a group of cells. First, the basically from the basic point of view, pathama. First, the living cells are made up of first atoms. Atoms are combined into molecules. Then molecules combine to form a cell organelles. Cell organelles to combine to form a cell. Cells to combine to form a tissue. Tissue to organ. Organ combined to form a organ system. Organ system combined to form a organism. Organisms combined to form a population. And population is combined to form a community. And community is combined to form a biome. Biome is the last category. Okay, then the organisms normally is a group of organisms, means an individual. Example, Homo sapiens, a single species. More Homo sapiens are present in one particular place, mean that is population. And population combined to, for example, cat population, dog population, human population, trees population, herbs population. So various plants or animals population combined to form a community, and community combined to form a biome. So this is all the basic level to higher level of biological classification, biological ecological classification abdinichikalam. Okay, so in this category, in this organisms and population lessons, various topics involved, like desert ecosystem, various type of ecosystem, small idea about ecosystem, temperature, how temperature, like abiotic factors which affect the ecosystem and affect the biological growth of the organisms. Separate area kuduthirpom, just a small story like structures la nariya kuduthirpom. For example, normally we know various plants and animals around you. What is the use of plants? Because plants only prepare their food, and the food is obtained by the animals from the plants, and plants also release oxygen during photosynthesis. Oxygen is useful for the organisms, animals particularly. Even plants also get oxygen from the photosynthesis for their respiration process. Okay, during photosynthesis the plants get carbon dioxide, but in respiration time plants also get oxygen. Okay, so where the season, our season is natural season, like rainy seasons. After rainy season, many frogs, insects are slowly developing, and the birds are singing in the seasonal activities. Why the birds are singing? How the birds are singing? The how means with the use of vocal cord, voice box. With the use of vocal cord, it is singing. Why the birds are singing? For attracting the partner, for mating purpose, for the reproduction purpose, for attracting the predators, for prey. So for various reason, the birds are singing. Okay, and why the night blooming flowers are like white? For example, why jasmine are white? Because jasmine flowering time, the bud into flowers means only during night time. It's early night or late night. Because the insects like jasmine, it attracts the insects for pollination. In the night time, this is colorful, means this is easily not identified by the insects. So in the night time, the jasmine is flowering, means in white color, its white color is attracted, is easily visible by the insects. So insects slowly visit and get pollinated and get nutrition like pollen and other things also. So only the night blooming flowers are white for attracting the insects, 1 point. It produces smell, scenty smell for attracting the insects. The day flowering scenty smell as compared to the night flowering scenty smell pathina is low, because this reason only, for attracting the insects for pollination, for attracting the bees, attracting the animals, attracting the birds for the pollination. Okay, so only the night blooming flowers are normally white in color. Okay, these are all a small idea about the ecosystem. Ecology, we know. Ecology means ecology. Eco means environment. Logy means to discourse or to study. To study about environment, to study about ecosystems, to study about environmental, abiotic and biotic components. The branch is known as ecology. Ecology la variety of branches we study. Like organisms, populations, biomes, different biomes in our lessons. Okay, this is actually a small idea about organisms and population. Next topic is organisms and its environment. Normally we know organisms are present in a or particular geographical area. For example, some camel present in a desert, polar bears present in a snow area. Then for example, amphibians are present in water related areas, and only bryophytes, pteridophytes are present in mountain areas which contain a low temperature, and lichens only present in pollutionless areas. This is polluted areas, lichen is absent. So the organisms are present in a geographical area which the organism's temperature and related to the environmental temperature and suitable for the organism's growth, survival and the reproduction. So the particular area which the organisms betterly survive. So the area is nothing but niche. Niche is nothing but that the area of an organism has survived. The area comprises all biotic and abiotic components and favorable for the particular organism's growth, like temperature, rainfall, precipitation. All these characters are favorable for the growth of the particular organism, means the area is known as a niche. Okay, then how the organisms are classified? Organisms or its environment are classified based on the temperature and the precipitation. Actually, in your NCRT book or graph like structure, I modify the graph into some format. Okay, that is with the use of annual precipitation, mean annual precipitation and the mean annual temperature, we categorize the biome, we categorize the area, we categorize the different forest, different ecosystem into different category, like desert ecosystem, grassland ecosystem, arctic and alpine tundra ecosystem, and coniferous forest ecosystem, and temperature forest ecosystem, and the tropical rainforest ecosystem. Okay, that the tropical forest or maybe in the tropical rainforest. According to this, so various ecosystems are classified. For example, you see in desert, only annual precipitation, mean annual precipitation is minus 50 centimeter. So in desert, the centimeter of rainfall is very very low, approximately minus 50 centimeters. Means if any desert get rain, so precipitation. And so annual temperature, mean annual temperature means normally 5 to 20 degrees Celsius. In desert, the annual precipitation is minus 50 and the mean annual temperature is 5 to 20. This is all is approximate value. Due to global warming, my value may change. This actually is the approximate values. And in grassland means annual rainfall is 550, minus 50 centimeter to 100 centimeter. 100 centimeter means actually in the rain gauge scale, and the centimeters are measured, the rainfall pattern. So annual mean annual precipitation in the grassland ecosystem means minus 50 to 100 centimeter annually. But in grassland, the temperature, mean annual temperature means 0 to 25. It's not done more 25. So 0 degree Celsius to 25 degree Celsius in various season. Suppose some season is 0, 5, 10, 12, 20, 25 also. So in grassland ecosystem, throughout the year, the temperature, we mean annual temperature means, analyzing the mean annual temperature means 0 to 25 in the grassland ecosystem. Suppose in Arctic and Alpine tundra ecosystem, Arctic region, the Antarctic region, the Alpine region means Alpine meadows, means the rainfall is minus 50 to 120, little bit extra from the grassland, the annual mean precipitation. The temperature also minus 10 degree Celsius to 0 degree or 1 or 2 degree Celsius only. So this is normally throughout the year under the zero condition. Okay, it's maximum 0 to 3 to 4 on the range now. So majority of the time, the annual mean annual temperature is only minus 10 to 0 degree Celsius. And the coniferous forest means in the mountain Himalayan forest in some part of the Western Ghats. The rainfall is minus 50 to 250 centimeter mean annual precipitation. So 50 lende minus 50 lende, maybe some rain coniferous forest not contain the rainfall. 250 centimeters will throughout the year changes in the precipitation. And in the temperature means 0 to 15 degrees Celsius. 0 will start panni 15 degrees Celsius on the temperature in the coniferous forest. Then in the temperate forest means minus 50 to 200 centimeters rainfall, temperate forests. And the temperature means 10 to 25 degree Celsius, and the mean annual temperature is 10 to 25 degree Celsius. And the tropical rainforest means 150 to 400 centimeters. So in the maximum rainfall, tropical rainforest. So 150 centimeter to 400, even above 400 also, the rainfall, the precipitation in the annual mean. And temperature also 20 to 25, not 0 to 3. So the maximum organisms are present in which type of ecosystem? According to your graph, according to your table, where the organisms are present in more as compared to that, because the tropical rainforest, because the rainfall pattern also more. So rain is important, water. So water is important for all these activities, all physiological, biochemical, all metabolic activities, plants, photosynthesis, transpiration, all the process, water is important. So water availability here is more in the tropical forests, tropical rainforests. So actually, the more plants and animals, diversity of plants, animals, microbes, other organisms are present in the tropical rainforest is most other compared to the other system. Even temperature also 20 to 25. So this temperature, the plants growth and metabolism, photosynthesis, all these activities done. So plants more means automatically consumers, primary, secondary consumers also most, because all the consumers depend on plants for their food. So according to this, which ecosystem, which environment has the lowest rainfall? Desert. Which ecosystem has the highest rainfall? tropical rainforest, tropical forest. Which ecosystem is a more temperatured, like grassland and temperate and tropical, more temperature? So which ecosystem has less temperature? Minus 10 here, Arctic and unfined tundra, the ecosystem only has less temperature. Okay, this is actually the graph in your NCERT. It like a graph form. I modify the graph into, for our convenience, changes into other tabular form. Okay, this is actually organisms and environment, and according to the precipitation and according to the mean temperature, the forest or the area is categorized into some ecosystem like desert, grassland, Arctic, coniferous and temperature, and temperate and tropical forests. Okay. So next one is major abiotic factors like temperature, water, then all the things. First we see the temperature, the first major abiotic factors. Normally biotic factors and abiotic factors, the categories into two, the normal environment ecosystem categories into abiotic components and the biotic components. Abiotic means non-living component like wind, water, temperature, rainfall, precipitation and fire, various soil, various atmosphere, various abiotic factors are present. So abiotic factors only determine the quality of the biotic factors, growth of the biotic factors. Suppose more temperature means only some archaebacteriums, thermoacetophils only present. Less temperature also only some snow leopard or some other organisms only present. So more temperature camel like cactus like organisms only in present in a desert area. But in a normal snow leopard in the only Arctic and the Antarctic region only. So penguin also present in a particular temperatures. Like temperature also is a one of the abiotic factor. According to the temperature variation only, the organism's population growth and survival and reproduction may take place. So some organisms we know that is a seasonal breeders. Only during the season only the breed. For example, frog, only after the rainy season it is reproduced because it need water for transferring the gametes. It is actually follows external fertilization. So without water the frog is not developed. So some organisms need a particular temperature for their growth, survival, reproduction, all the things, all the biochemical and metabolic process. In more temperature the organisms not survive. For example, mango tree is not present in, not grow in Canada and Germany because Canada and Germany is a cold climate countries. In India its climate is different as compared to the Canada and Germany. So even mountain areas in Ooty, metropolitan Ooty also, is mango tree is not present because the particular low temperatures the mango tree is actually a mesophyte, present in the normal areas, not a hydrophyte, not a xerophyte. So mango is present in our locality, in our Dharmaburi or Salem district or other districts. But in Ooty or maybe in Erkad, the mango tree is not present. Even normal neem tree, Azadirachta indica, normal neem tree is not present in our mountain areas like German and other things. Because that organism, the trees need a particular proper temperature for their growth, survival and the metabolism. So mango tree is not, does not grow in Canada like countries because the here Canada and Germany is more less temperatured countries, 0-5 the range is on. So same like snow leopard is not present in Kerala like Western Ghats because snow leopards need a less temperature. So in Western Ghats the temperature is less but not like snow. So in a snow leopard and absent in, so idilirund enna solla varanga, the temperature is important for the organism's growth. Even temperature is important for the enzymes kinetics because salivary amylase in our body it's a perform starch digestion only in 37 degrees Celsius. Suppose we get fever, the temperature is increased into 39, maybe 40 degrees Celsius. So in 40 degree Celsius, our enzymes do not work because enzymes are proteins. Due to temperature, proteins are breaking with a peptide bond. Only joins the amino acid to form a protein. So peptide bonds break, Ashna. The proteins are denatured. The amino acids are denatured. So with the temperature, all the enzymes are degraded. So without enzymes, no biological process, no metabolic pathways, no metabolic process like anabolic, catabolic, all this process is not taking place. So temperature is important factor for the organism's growth and survival and all physiochemical metabolic activities. So next one. So according to the temperature, organisms are categorized into two: urethermal and steenothermal. Urethermal organism means a wide range of temperatures. The organism present in any temperature region. Abdin sonnomna, the organisms are urethermal. For example, human present in everywhere. In German also, human beings are present. In Tamil Nadu also, human being present. In African desert also, human beings. Maybe with the use of external structure, maybe modified. Adu koncham use aagudhu. But organisms are present in wide range of temperature. For example, organisms -10 la irukku, +20 la irukku. So wide range of temperature la the organisms are present, survive and metabolism, all this biochemical process taking place means the organisms are what? Urethermal organism. Example, human beings and birds. And steenothermal organism means only a certain range, the narrow range of temperature, only a small, for example, only 10 to 20 and the temperature la the organisms are moving. Beyond the 20, the organisms are died. And the organisms are moving to the -10, -5 means the organisms are died without any physiological process. So only the small wide range of temperature, the narrow range of temperature, only small narrow range of temperature la the organisms survive, mean the organisms are steenothermal organisms. Now humans and birds like mammals and birds like organisms in wide range of temperature la survive. So on the particular organism is urethermal. According to the temperature, one of the abiotic factors, organisms are classified into two categories: urethermal, present in wide range of temperature, and the steenothermal are present in narrow range of temperature. Okay, so temperature is one of the abiotic factors and the growth of living organisms and growth of kinetics, enzymes and physiochemical and biochemical and metabolic process according to the temperature may vary. Okay, so temperature is one of the abiotic factor which is important for the organism's growth, organism survival, organism's development. Okay. Next one is major abiotic factors is water. So water, we know that all the physiochemical process need water. Biological process, metabolic process, even photosynthesis. The use of water only, the first step in photosynthesis is what? Breaking the water molecules with the use of sunlight. That the process is photolysis and releasing of oxygen. So without water, plants not release oxygen. So without oxygen, animals, the primary consumer, secondary, tertiary consumers, and the consumers survive. So consumers like animals need oxygen for their respiration. For oxygen production, plants only breaking the water and release oxygen. So without water, the organisms are not survive. So water is important, most important factor, abiotic factors for the organism survival. Even normally we thinking that the animals present inside the water is not have any problem because the more abundance of water, and ellame water free ah kadaikudhu, so water scarcity edhum kadaikadhu nam think panom, but that is not actually true. Animals present in the water, the aquatic animals also some problems related to the water because the water has a chemical composition. So some plants and some animals need a particular chemicals present in the water, so only it is respire and it photosynthesis all these minerals and absorbs. The chemical composition is different means the plants and animals also not survive. and pH. The next one is pH, potentiality of hydrogen, power of hydrogen. So normally one particular water contains some pH. Normally pH range what? 0 to 14. 0 to 6.9 is acidic. 7 is actually neutral, and 7.1 to 14 is base. So some organism present in acidic water condition, but is not survive in the basic condition, basic water condition. So the pH of the water also equally important for the organism survival, even plants as well as animals. Suppose the pH changes means from acid to base, means organisms also not survive, because pH is important for the survival of the organisms. And salinity, salinity means salt concentration in water. Some fish are present in fresh water like katla and rohu in our area, rivers and dam, but pampered like fish only present in marine water. The pampered fish is present in the fresh water, because this is osmotic problems, because we know that is osmosis, the movement of water inside the cell. Amoeba movement of water from inside the cell, outside the cell. The movement of water from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. Suppose for freshwater fish means a more water concentration inside the tissue. Then the freshwater fish is taken into the marine water, means the marine water salt concentration only more, but the water concentration is less. So automatically from inside the water is move outside the cell. So automatically if you grow a freshwater fish in the marine water, means automatically it shrinks due to exosmosis. Suppose you grow a marine water fish into the fresh water, means the inside the marine water fish the water concentration is low, but in fresh water the water concentration is more. So we grow the marine fish in a fresh water, means due to endosmosis the fish cells bulge and even die. So this is osmotic problem. So due to osmotic problem also is important for the survival of the fish. Not only fish, other aquatic animals also, even plants also. So osmolarity, salinity also important, salt concentration. Salinity is nothing but salt concentration, also important for the survival of animals. So normally salt, salinity is measured in PPT. PPT means parts per thousand. In 1000 ml of water, how salt is present, how many percentage of salt is present, how many gram. For example, normal inland water bodies means in like lake, pond, dam, like inland water bodies normally contain 5 ppt only in 1000. For example, we take 1000 ml of நார்மல் பாண்ட் வாட்டர் அப்படின்னு சொன்னோம்னா அதில் ஒன்லி 5 கிராம் ஆஃப் சால்ட் இஸ் ஆடட், 5 கிராம் ஆஃப் மினரல்ஸ் ஆர் ஆடட், நாட் ஒன்லி சால்ட் மினரல்ஸ் ஆர் ஆடட். ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி இருந்துச்சுன்னா த வாட்டர் இஸ் செட் டு பி அ இன்லேண்ட் வாட்டர். 5 per 1000, 5 parts per 1000, நாட் பர் 100, பர் 1000. ஸோ 30 to 35 மீன்ஸ் இன் த சீ வாட்டர். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், டேக் ஆன் 1000 ml ஆஃப் சீ வாட்டர் மீன்ஸ் in the 1000 ml 30 to 35 gram actually minerals. So 30 to 35 grams minerals irundhuchana actually this is sea water. Then more than 100 in some hypersaline sea, for some hypersaline lagoons na the river and sea joining place, aduk pakkathula or small island mar irukum, the area surrounding the island is lagoons. அந்த லாங்கூன்ஸில் இருக்கிற சம் வாட்டரை டெஸ்ட் பண்ணினா இட் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி மோர் தேன் ஹண்ட்ரட் மீன்ஸ் இன் 1000 ml ஆஃப் வாட்டரில் மோர் தேன் ஹண்ட்ரட் கிராம் ஆஃப் சால்ட் அண்ட் மினரல்ஸ் ஆர் ப்ரெசன்ட். ஸோ அக்கார்டிங் டு த பர்சன்ட் ஆஃப் பார்ட்ஸ் பர் 1000, த வாட்டர் இஸ் கிளாஸிஃபைட் இன் டு இன்லேண்ட் வாட்டர் பாடிஸ் தட் இஸ் 5, அண்ட் சீ வாட்டர் 30 to 35 இன் 1000. And more than 100 means that is hypersaline lagoons, so sea water, more salty sea water like dead sea water. Then, according to the water concentration, organisms are categorized into urehaline and stenohaline. Same like urethermal and stenothermal. Mari ingiyum urehaline and stenohaline. The wide range of salinities. For example, some fish present in all the range of salinities. For fresh water la irukum, more concentrated salt water, sea water la irukum. Some fish and the more hypersaline water la irukum. So andha mari wide range of salinity la the organisms are present. Mean the organisms are said to be urehaline. And stenohaline means narrow range of salinities. Only for example, normal katla is present only in fresh water like river. Suppose we move to more salt concentration water, means the katla and rogi is not present, it is able to not develop. It is all physiological and metabolic process is controlled. So the type of organisms are stenohaline. Only narrow range of narrow range of salinity. ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் ரேஞ்சுக்குள்ளே சால்ட் இருந்தால் மட்டும் த சர்வை வாட்சினா த ஆர்கானிசம்ஸ் ஆர் ஸ்டீனோஹாலைன் ஆர்கானிசம்ஸ். அந்த வைட் ரேஞ்ச் ஆஃப் சால்ட் கான்சன்ட்ரேஷன்லேயும் இந்த ஆர்கானிசம்ஸ் ஆர் பிளான்ஸ் ஆல்சோ கன் சர்வை மீன் தட் இஸ் ஆர்கானிசம்ஸ் ஆர் யூரிஹாலைன் நாட் ஓன்லி அனிமல்ஸ் ஈவன் பிளான்ஸ் ஆல்சோ சம் பிளான்ஸ். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ரெட் ஆல்கே இஸ் நாட் ப்ரெசன்ட் இன் ஃப்ரெஷ் வாட்டர் இன்லேண்ட் வாட்டர். க்ரீன் ஆல்கே இஸ் நாட் ப்ரெசன்ட் இன் ரெட் வாட்டர். திஸ் இஸ் ரெட் வாட்டர் மீன்ஸ் இட்ஸ் சீ வாட்டர். பிகாஸ் குளோரெல்லா இஸ் அ க்ரீன் ஆல்கே. ஸ்பைரோகைரா இஸ் அ க்ரீன் ஆல்கே. Semitesmus and Cygnema, Eudoconium, so all this green algae is not grow in a salt water like sea, because this green algae is actually a stenohaline. Even algae, red algae is also a stenohaline, only present in salt water. Suppose you grow a red algae in normal water, means normal inland water, means this does not develop, it is does not reproduce and develop into a new organism, that is stenohaline. So wide range of salt la survive achana the organisms are urehaline. Only a small range of narrow range of salinity la the organisms are survive achana, that is actually stenohaline. According to the salinity, salt concentration, survival which organisms are categorized into urehaline and the stenohaline. Okay.